In the 1950s, the church still played a big part in people's lives. Jenny was a minister's daughter, so it was essential to find a church to join. The Netherlands has a rich history when it comes to religion. For a long time, the Dutch lived their lives in their own community based on the Christian denomination they belonged to and the associated political beliefs. These pillars, as they were called, even had their own newspapers, radio, and television stations. Coming from this background, it isn't surprising that Cor and Jenny were looking to join a church that specifically matched the community they had grown up in. There were 104 different types of churches in Pasadena, but they were looking for a Christian Reformed church, which was founded in the US by Dutch immigrants and was the equivalent of the church they had been going to back home. There wasn't one in Pasadena, but their friends Leen and Ank recommended a Christian Reformed church in Arcadia, about 10 kilometers east of Pasadena. It still exists today and is called Hope International Church. The church was very much like the one they were used to, with a few exceptions. There was a nursery for children up to the age of 3, and every Sunday, a shift of about 5 mothers took care of the children so their parents could attend the service. This was something that didn't exist in the Netherlands yet, and Cor and Jenny were all for it. From the age of 3 onwards, children were allowed at the service, but Jenny thought it would be an impossible task to try to keep them quiet. Another difference was that the offering was collected on an open plate instead of in the discreet cloth bag they were used to. This is a good example of cultural differences. In the Netherlands, people prefer to keep how much they can give private, and in the US, they are more open about showing how much money they choose to donate. The congregation was made up of about 250 people. Among the church members were many Dutch immigrants, both old and new. Their names were pronounced differently, of course, because they had been anglicized. Everyone was very welcoming. They were invited over for more cups of coffee than they would be able to drink. The church organized picnics regularly in one of the parks in Arcadia, where they also played volleyball. For young couples, the church had a Mr. and Mrs. Club. In the Netherlands, there were separate clubs for men and women. Through the church, they were getting the chance to make new acquaintances and friends from the same cultural background. Gezelligheid was a leading factor, and they found that Americans didn't quite have that Dutch cozy touch. At the same time, Cor and Jenny were learning about religions other than the ones they were familiar with. Their new downstairs neighbors were Mormons. They'd only read about this religion, and Jenny never thought she would ever get to meet them in real life. He was an astronomy professor at Caltech with his wife and 5 children. They looked very normal and were very kind. Jenny had looked up the term Mormons in the dictionary, and the entry said something about polygamy, so she asked her father what he knew about this and if that element was still practiced today. It had piqued their interest because in September of 1959, during one of their road trips, they traveled to Utah and visited the Mormon temple in Salt Lake City.